Hello video creators, welcome to Storysium. In this Premiere Pro tutorial, I will show you how you can make texts pop in while you're talking, similar to the text that you're watching now. As you'll see, it's some pretty basic stuff, and it can be done in older versions of Premiere as well. And I'm going to show you how after the message of our sponsor Envato Elements. It doesn't matter if you create videos for a living or just for a hobby, you need to know about Envato Elements. And that's because they offer millions of high quality assets for your video projects, all within one single subscription. And this includes stock video, music and sound effects, fonts, video animation templates and much more. I've got my own paid subscription for a couple of years now, and I still visit the website multiple times a week for many of my projects. So I can highly recommend you to give it a try. Please use the link in the description to check them out and also support my channel. Okay, now it's time to start some editing. Inside Premiere, I've already got this voiceover sample ready on the timeline. Let's have a quick listen to the sample that we're going to use for the demo. Hello video creators, welcome to Storysium. We're going to start by adding text to the timeline. I'm going to do this with the Type tool. And this tool is part of the Essential Graphics panel, which is available in the latest versions of CC 2017 and newer. If you use an even older version of Premiere, you need to use the Title Editor. And to do this, you need to go to the Project panel, click the New Item icon and then select Title. As you can see, it is not in my list because I'm using a newer version of Premiere. And as I said, I will use the Type tool, which you can find here by the way, or use the T key to enable it. And now with the Type tool enabled, I can start typing inside the program monitor. In this case, we're going to divide the voiceover into layers. What I mean is, when I want to create something like this, it will take 4 lines or 4 layers of text. So let's start with the first layer, and that will be the word hello. And after that, I can go back to the selection tool by clicking this icon here. Then I'm going to duplicate the layer by holding the Alt key combined with the left mouse button and then drag it up to the next track. And as I said, we're going to use 4 lines for this one, so we need 4 copies of the text layer. And after that, I will reposition the text somewhere randomly in the program monitor so we can edit the text. As you can see, I've got the second text layer selected, so now I will double click on it and then change this into Video Creators. Okay, now we can select the next one, which is the third track as you can see, and we're going to change this one into Welcome To. And we're going to repeat the same step for the final layer, and we're going to change this one into Storysium. And after that, we can go back to the selection tool again by clicking this icon. The next step is optional, but I think it will make it look a lot better, and that is changing the weight of the font. Most fonts, like the Montserrat font that I'm using for this tutorial, have different weight or styles options. And in this case, I will randomly assign some different weights or styles to the words to stylize the text. Okay, in the next step we're going to position the text, and to do this we're going to make use of rulers. And to activate this, you can hover over the ruler here on the side until this icon appears, and then with the left mouse button drag it onto your program monitor. I don't think that this one has to be super precise, but it's always nice to have a guideline. Oh, and by the way, if you don't see the rulers, you might need to activate them first. You can do this by clicking here on this wrench icon and then enable them here. And after that, it's all a matter of repositioning, scaling or resizing and stacking the text. Like I said, it doesn't have to be very precise, but try to keep them between the lines of the rulers and you should be fine. And of course, I'm going a little faster because I don't want this tutorial to last forever, but just take the time and make your version look even better. Okay, that should do it for now. Let's remove the rulers and then start by matching the words or the text with the voiceover. And we're going to start here by aligning the text layers with the spoken words. If you look at the waveform, you can see that the first word, hello, starts here. And that's also the point where we're going to start the first text layer. Then I will scrub to the timeline and listen to the voiceover to find the start of the following line, video creators. This sounds like the right point, so that's where I'm going to move layer number 2. Next, I'm going to move the third line to the point where Welcome To starts. Video creators. And finally, the fourth line, Storysium, should start somewhere here. But to be sure, let's have a listen. Welcome to Yes, that sounds like the right point, and this is what we've got so far. Hello video creators, welcome to Storysium. In the next step, we're going to cut all the text layers at the point where the voiceover ends, and that's here. And we're going to do this with the Razor tool, which you can enable here, or hit the C key to enable it. And then, with the Razor tool enabled, you can hold Ctrl plus Shift, and then with the left mouse button, cut all the tracks at once. And then, you can select all the cutoff parts and then remove them by hitting the Delete key. Next, we're going to make individual words pop in. The first line, hello, already is a single word, so we're going to start with the next one, video creators. First, I'm going to scrub to the timeline to find the point where the second word starts. Okay, this sounds like the point where the second word creators starts. And now we can move over to the effects panel to apply an effect. In the effects panel, I'm going to search for the crop effect. You'll find this one under video effects transform. And I'm going to apply this effect to the second text layer video creators. The playhead is still at the point where the second word starts, so now we can move over to the effects control panel. And in there, we're going to enable keyframes for the right crop value by clicking on the stopwatch icon here. This has created the first keyframe, which we're going to increase in percentage until only the first word is visible. And that's 95% in this case. Next, I'm going to change this keyframe into a hold keyframe by right-clicking on it and then select hold. And then I'm going to move this hold keyframe to the beginning, because that's the word that we want to start with. And then I'm going to change the value back to 0%. This will create a second keyframe, still at the point of the playhead where the second word starts. And now if I scrub to the timeline, you can see the second word pop in at the point where we use the hold keyframe. Next, I'm going to repeat the same steps for the welcome to text layer. So this means that I'm going to add the crop effect and then find the point where the second word starts. Welcome. Okay, so that sounds like the point where 2 starts. We can now move over to the effects control panel and enable keyframes for the right crop value. Then adjust the percentage and change this into a hold keyframe. Move that keyframe to the beginning, then make another keyframe with value 0, and there you go. Video creators, welcome to Storysium. And finally, I'm also going to do something different with the word Storysium. For this one, we'll also add the crop effect, but inside the effects control panel, we're not going to use hold keyframes. But instead, we're going to use the linear keyframes with values 0 to 100. We're going to move these keyframes to the beginning and the end, and for the first keyframe, we're going to use the option Ease Out, and for the second one, we're going to use Ease In. And these Ease options will make the animation a bit more smoother. Okay, and this is how the linear keyframes look. To Storysium. It's time to see this all together, so let's have a look at the final result. Hello video creators, welcome to Storysium. And as an appreciation for the fact that you're still here, I'm going to show you how I made the colored backgrounds that you saw at the beginning of this video. But before I start that, I wanted to ask you to consider to subscribe to my channel. And that's because the YouTube analytics tell me that more than 80% of my viewers are not subscribed. So it would be really awesome if you could help me to increase the percentage of subscribed viewers. Anyway, it's time to continue to the final part, showing you how to make the colored backgrounds. First, I'm going to make some room for the background layer by moving the text layers up. Then I'm going to add a color mat. You can do this in the project panel, go to the new item icon and then select color mat. You can accept the default settings and you don't need to pick a color because we will adjust this later on with an effect. After you click OK, you can find the color mat here in the project panel. Let's drag it over to the timeline and then place this under the text layers. I will also shorten the length of the color mat so it will match with the duration of the voiceover. Next, we're going to add an effect. In the effects panel, we're going to search for 4 color gradient. You can find this one under video effects generate. I'm going to apply this effect to the color mat and you'll see the results right away. Okay, now it's time to adjust this effect in the effects control panel. First, I'm going to change one of the colors into a more bluish color, but of course you can pick any color that you prefer. And then I'm going to change all the other colors into the same blue color. And after that, I will adjust this by picking a slightly lighter or darker tint. This way, the colors will match pretty well and you will also get this nice subtle gradient as you can see here in the program monitor. And as a final touch, we're going to animate this gradient. First, I'm going to enable keyframes for the 4 gradient points. Then I'll move these 4 keyframes to the beginning and then select the 4 color gradient effect. This will make the 4 blue crosshairs available as you can see here in the program monitor. We can now simply move these points to another position, and by changing the position, Premiere created a new set of keyframes for us. We can move these keyframes to the end, and now we've got this nice animation happening on the gradient position points. And of course, you can add much more keyframes, and you can even add keyframes for the colors. Anyway, that's it for this bonus part and also for the rest of this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, you might also want to check out one of these two videos. As always, I would like to say thanks for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.